King Vikramaditya and the Thieves. King Vikramaditya was once very agitated. There was a sudden spurt of thefts in the kingdom, and nobody had been able to catch the thief or thieves so far. It was quite unheard of. Every effort had failed, and no one had any idea as to who the culprits might be. "Thieves in Ujjaini? It's quite disgraceful. What's wrong with all of you?" said King Vikramaditya, addressing the royal guards. "Sir, we have tried our best. We just can't lay our hands on them. They seem to get away every time," said the guard in charge.
"Obviously, they are cleverer. Looks as though I will have to attend to this myself. Very well, you may go. I will see what I can do," said the king.
That night, King Vikramaditya disguised himself as a common man and stood waiting patiently at one of the important crossroads. Hours passed by and nothing unusual happened. Then, soon after it struck midnight, four men came from four different directions and seemed to utter something like a password. As they stood talking earnestly amongst themselves, one of them suddenly caught sight of the king.
"Who are you? What is your trade?"
they asked suspiciously. "I am Prajapal," said the king, giving them a broad smile. "My profession? I guess it's the same as yours. In fact, I had been waiting for you."
"Really? Then tell us where we are going."
"I can't be sure, but I expect you are bound for merchant Dhanapati's house. His ship has just returned after a profitable trip abroad."
"Ha, right you are. You're obviously one of us. Join our group then. The more the merrier," said the leader.
"I would be glad to, but I have a suggestion," said the king.
"What is it?"
asked the thieves curiously. "Let's go to the royal palace instead. After all, how much money can a mere merchant possess? No matter how well he trades, the king is bound to have much more," said the king. The thieves looked at one another. Then the leader said,
"No doubt you are right, but going to the palace would be far too risky. What if we are caught? The royal guards are far too many in number. Dhanapati's house would be safer."
"That's exactly why I'm here for. You won't get caught at the palace if I'm there. Now you had better tell me what each of you specializes in and how we are going to divide the booty," said the king.
"In 5 equal parts, of course," said the leader at once.
"And your special talent?"
"I can smell the air and identify what is inside a locked room," said the first thief. "I can open any lock, no matter how tough," said the second.
"I never forget a voice," said the third.
"And I can understand the language of birds and animals," said the leader of the gang.
"Very good. We should have no problem then," said the king. They made for the palace, the king leading the way. They were soon at the royal treasury. There was no guard at the door, as Vikramaditya had tactfully sent him on another errand.
"Why don't you smell the air and tell us what is in each of the rooms?" suggested King Vikramaditya.
The first thief soon gave them a detailed and totally correct list. "I think we had better stick to precious gems. It will be easy to divide," said the king thoughtfully.
"Yes, they are all in separate caskets," said the first thief.
"Well then, let's each pick up one. Might be dangerous if we take too many. After all, we don't want to run risks," said the king. The second thief touched the lock and it burst open immediately. They got in and each of them picked up a casket. Just then, a jackal howled outside. The leader cried,
"The jackal is saying, how do you dare steal when the owner of the treasure is watching you? I think we had better leave the caskets and go back.
Don't be silly. I'm sure you haven't understood the jackal, said Vikramaditya.
How can the king possibly watch us when he is fast asleep inside the palace?
I'm sure Prajapal is right, said the other three. It would be foolish to go back empty-handed when we have come this far. And there's no king anywhere that we can see.
Come on, all of you, said the king.
The jackal howled once again, this time louder.
What are they saying?
The three thieves asked once again.
The leader looked perplexed. They are saying, how can the owner let you people get away with the theft? It's really funny.
What can that mean? Asked the other three.
There's no one watching us.
Don't worry about it. You have simply misunderstood the jackals, that's all, said King Vikramaditya.
Come on, don't tarry inside the palace any longer. We don't want to get caught.
Once they were out on the road, the leader said, Prajapal, thanks to you, we could get all these precious gems. We could never have managed it otherwise.
I'm glad I could be of help. But actually, it is the efforts of all of us put together that we could get the caskets, said the king smiling.
What should we do tomorrow night? Asked the leader.
Don't wait for the night. Let's meet at the same crossing at midday. And remember, each of us should carry a big lemon. That would be our password.
Very well, said the thieves and departed for the night. King Vikramaditya hid his own casket of gems and went back to sleep. The next morning, there was a commotion in the palace as soon as the royal treasurer discovered the missing caskets. King Vikramaditya sent for the chief of the royal guards and blamed him for the theft in the palace. He said, "Since you aren't able to catch the thief, you will have to bear the punishment." The guard was really upset. He knew that he had done everything possible and it was not really his fault. He begged the king to reconsider his decision.
I know I haven't been careless, sir, but if you want to punish me for my ill luck, I shall accept it, he said.
Before I actually punish you, I want you to do something. Go to the main crossroads at midday and catch hold of four men who will be carrying a lemon each, said the king.
Very well, sir, said the guard and left for the city, wondering what the king meant by his strange request. Before long, the four thieves were caught and produced before the king.
Four caskets full of precious gems were stolen from the palace last night, said King Vikramaditya. Since you're the four who stole them, you had better return them fast.
We are innocent, sir. We know nothing about any theft whatsoever, cried three of the thieves.
Could we speak to you alone for a moment, sir? Asked the third thief.
The king told the others to go out and face them alone.
Sir, I never forget a voice, said the third thief. I know it was you who met us last night and took us to the palace in the guise of Prajapal.
Oh, I suppose that's why the jackal said all those strange things, cried the leader.
The other two had already taken off the caskets they had stolen.
Please forgive us and take back what we stole last night.
I shall forgive you provided all of you promise never to steal again as long as you live, said King Vikramaditya.
We shall not, we promise, said all four together.
King Vikramaditya presented them with land, cattle and houses so that they could lead a respectable life. And there was no theft in Ujjaini anymore.